Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I'm Dr. Sangeeta Sharma Dhar, Assistant Professor, Department of Social Work, Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar College, University of Delhi. We are going to discuss today the topic, Community Engagement in HIV/AIDS Prevention in India, from paper, Human Resource Development Through Community Engagement. HIV/AIDS is an endemic that is affecting hidden population. Hence, engaging communities in containing it was adapted as one of the most important strategies of prevention efforts. HIV is an ever-moving pandemic. First detected in 1981 in USA, in 1986 in India, it was detected in Tamil Nadu. Initially perceived as a medical problem, it moved on to become a public health issue and later a developmental issue. It is affecting the productive population of the nation. Many disciplines have responded to this, ranging from economics to psychology. Let us have a look at some of the facts related to HIV. It is the greatest pandemic where 71 million are infected till date. It is fourth biggest killer with 34 million have died till date. Total infected are 36.7 million and new infections 2.1 million as per the latest data by UNAIDS 2016. Latest data about India sourced from UNAIDS Gap Report 2016. There were 2.1 million people living with HIV, 0.3% HIV adult prevalence, 86,000 new HIV infections and 68,000 AIDS related deaths. 43% adults were on ART. Routes of transmission. As per NACO, 87.1% of the total HIV infections were found in heterosexual people. Parents to child transmission was found in 5.4%. 1.5% infections were taking place in homosexual persons. 1.6% infections were taking place in injecting drug users. 1% were found to be infected by blood and blood products, and 3.3% of the HIV positive persons were infected from unknown reasons. Routes of HIV transmission. There are a lot of myths and misconceptions about routes of HIV transmission. HIV is an infection which can be transmitted by various routes. It is an infection which has a history, a pattern, and an unprecedented stigma associated. Historically, it was found to have affected and infected the gay or homosexual communities, followed by female sex workers and later the intravenous drug users. It is affecting people from all walks of life, but it is affecting these populations more. This population is considered as violators of social normative behavior. They are considered deviants, hence are marginalized from the society due to their sexual behavior or drug injecting or drug inducing practices which are illegal. HIV is the only infection of current scenario which has suffered from unsurmountable stigma. This infection is transmitted through sexual routes by sharing body fluids like blood, semen or vaginal fluids. New infections? Let's have a look at it. If the infected does not transmit the virus to another person in his or her lifetime, the reproductive rate of the virus is said to be zero. If we achieve this, we can avert the pandemic. But this does not happen and new infections occur. Myths and misconceptions. You all will be happy to know that HIV is not transmitted by air or water. Saliva, sweat, tears or close mouth kissing. Insects or pets. Sharing toilets, foods or drinks. The context of India is laden with values like patriarchy, brahmacharya, chastity, virginity and sexuality. The patriarchy says that men are to take decisions. Brahmacharya says sexual abstinence till adulthood. Chastity means monogamy, which is not in practice. Virginity only for women. Men are expected to be experienced. Sexuality, where heterosexuality is the norm, otherwise it is considered a crime. Few hard facts about HIV. No cure exists for AIDS, but strict adherence to antiretroviral regimen helps. ARVs can dramatically slow disease's progression as well as prevent transmission. Secondary infections and complications are to be managed lifelong. Person may experience pain areas in the abdomen, pain circumstances which can occur while swallowing, cough which could be dry, whole body fatigue, fever, loss of appetite, malaise, night sweats or sweating. Gastrointestinal issues could be there with nausea, persistent diarrhea, vomiting. People may experience in mouth ulcers or white tongue, in groin areas sores or swelling, in throat difficulty swallowing or soreness, headache, opportunistic infection, oral thrush, pneumonia are also common. Red blotches, several severe unintentional weight loss could be there. Skin rash or swollen lymph could be found. Key population infected by HIV. Year 2008-2009 indicates that 7.2% of injecting drug users, 7.4% of MSM and 5.1% of FSW are HIV positive. In 2015, we found 2.2% female sex workers, 4.3% MSM and 7% transgender and 7.5% intravenous drug users infected with HIV, which shows shift in the behavior of female sex workers. Stigma. The term stigma used to refer an attribute that is deeply discrediting, an attribute that stigmatizes one type of possessor can confirm the usualness of another. Let us have a look at the efficiency of the infection. The efficiency of the infection depends upon the route of transmission as well as the viral load of that route. This further is impacted by the presence of an already existing laceration, abrasion or injury at the point of contact. For example, the sexual transmission as such is the least efficient way of getting infected, but presence of an already existing STD may aggravate the efficiency by 20%. Unprotected vaginal intercourse with an HIV positive man who is chronically infected and not on antiretroviral treatment carries an estimated 0.08% risk of infection for the woman per sexual act. The risk of a man who has unprotected vaginal intercourse with an HIV positive woman who is chronically infected and not on antiretroviral treatment is estimated to be 0.04% per sexual contact. This may explain the increasing number of women who are HIV positive. Women's sexuality is specially circumscribed by cultural values and practices. The onset of menarche in girls sets the stage for a restrictive environment both inside and outside the home. In a culture where chastity is more cherished and more precious than life itself, girls are over-socialized from childhood to accept their subservient role in a patriarchal setup, to learn modesty and self-denial, and to develop proficiency in household tasks and childcare through intensive participation in the native home, where they are considered guests till they marry. Protection of virginity is a key message in young girls' sexual socialization in many cultures. Where virginity among girls is highly valued, young women are inhibited from seeking out sexual and reproductive health information and services. India, which is a land of multiple taboos on sexual behavior, propagates heterosexual relations. This is observed that socio-cultural milieu shapes the attitudes favoring the normative sexuality, but as the individual finds himself in contrast to what he or she believes to be normative, he develops a sense of shame around his behavior. The stigma, as identified by Herrick, is enacted, felt, and internalized. The sense of personal responsibility for acquiring the infection leads to internalized stigma. Social construction of the disease. Every disease has a kind of social image which is ascribed to the person suffering from that disease. The stigma, which was associated with the groups, spilled over to the infection, leading to the situation where infection itself became a cause of stigma. Every disease has one or the other kind of social construction, depending upon the way in which it is acquired and on the kind of persons acquiring it. Let's have a look at the key population infected by HIV. As per the latest estimates, 2.2% female sex workers, 4.3% men having sex with men, 7% transgender, 7.5% intravenous drug users are infected with HIV as per the estimates from 2007 to 2015. Stigma is the third epidemic. First being increasing HIV and second being ever increasing number of AIDS patients. The term stigma then will be used to refer to an attribute that is deeply discrediting. But it should be seen that a language of relationship, not attributes, is really needed. An attribute that stigmatizes one type of possessor can conform the usualness of another. This is given by Hoffman. This stigma has occurred because we have been believing in a just world society. This just world belief has led to the stigma. It is perceived for the society to be just and fair. And if some wrong treatment is meted out to some, stigma in case of AIDS resulting in discrimination, it is only because they might have behaved in certain way to have deserved this treatment, thus justifying the discriminatory behavior. Just world beliefs, wherein it is perceived for the society to be just and fair, and if some wrong treatment is meted out to some, stigma in case of AIDS resulting in discrimination, for example, it is only because they might have behaved in certain way to have deserved this treatment, thus justifying the discriminatory behavior. As Brenda Du Bois has beautifully written about societal response to the victim while quoting Ryan, in contemporary society, blaming the victim is an ideology that emphasizes environmental causation rather than one that regards victim as inferior, genetically defective, or morally unfit from birth. Although this interpretation considers environmental influences, sympathetic social scientists and liberal politicians explain that forces of circumstances have made people inferior. Thus, even when people consider the social circumstances of poverty, they blame victims for their lower status. Although problems and the resulting social stigma originate in external forces, people attribute it causes to some defect in victims. For example, social change agents condemn the environmental effect of poverty, injustice, and discrimination, and yet they ironically direct their efforts at changing victims. To quote Ryan, 1976, all this happens so smoothly that it seems downright rational. First, identify a social problem. Second, study those affected by the problem and discover in what way they are different from rest of us as a consequence of deprivation and injustice. Third, define the difference as the case of the social problem itself. And finally, of course, assign a bureaucrat to invent a humanitarian action program to correct the differences. This was quoted from Du Bois B. Response to the discrimination. The natural response to the discriminatory behavior is cocooning and hiding the status from the society. Hidden population. Stigma makes the intervention very difficult. As there is no symptom and cause is a private behavior of the person, hence this group is called hidden population. Reaching out to them is a challenge. Therefore, it is very important to engage the communities of these people in the prevention efforts. Community engagement. Community engagement can take many forms, and partners can include organized groups, agencies, institutions, or individuals. If we look at the continuum of community engagement, we see that HIV positive people are given care and support services. People who are having STD, TB, they are sent to ICTC counseling center for HIV test and linking them to the appropriate agencies. The people who are in high risk groups are being reached out through peers and stakeholders, and transmission prevention, supply of commodities like condom and needle and syringe as well as blood safeties are there for transmission prevention. Steps in involvement of communities in public health. Awareness generation. Number 2, removal of myths and misconceptions. Number 3, explanation of the behavior and the causes behind the homosexual behavior or IDUs, and creation of workforce to identify the vulnerable persons. And number 4, creating a task force of community volunteers. Number 5, major thrust on counseling. Number 6, accessing vulnerability. Number 7, behavior change. Number 8, use of information, education and communication. Now let us have a look at the government response to HIV/AIDS. Establishment of National AIDS Control Organization. National AIDS Control Policy 1, 2, 3 and 4 have been the responses of the government to HIV prevention efforts. Government response to HIV. NACP4 had two objectives. Reduce new infections by 50% of the 2007 baseline of NACP3, and provide comprehensive care and support to all persons living with HIV and treatment services for all those who require it. Besides that, we have Link Worker Scheme. This scheme has been initiated keeping in view the needs of the rural community, with special focus on HRG, that is high risk groups and highly vulnerable community. Next is blood safety. We are continuing with blood safety. All blood which is donated is screened for HIV. Separation of blood parts is being encouraged. Next is integrated counseling and testing centers. ICTCs are established across for HIV testing, pre-test and post-test counseling, which is conducted on each patient, and positive ones are registered for antiretroviral therapy. The next is the management of sexually transmitted diseases. AIDS control program has been linked with STI, that is sexually transmitted infection, and RTI, that is reproductive tract infections, clinic services at district and teaching hospitals. STI clinics at targeted interventions along with links with the private preferred provider for community-based STI is provided to high-risk population. Information, education and communication, we are still continuing with this component. This focuses on behavior change with the aim of developing enabling environment and focuses on reducing stigma and discrimination attached with the infection. Condom is the most effective prophylaxis against HIV, and scaling up of socially marketed condoms is taking place along with the distribution of condoms to identified high risk groups. If we look at the organizational structure of National AIDS Control Organization, it has NACO at the top with states AIDS control organizations at the base, and then non-governmental organization at the grassroots level. The targeted intervention projects have a wonderful hierarchical structure with the project manager at the top who looks at the project and reports to the project director. He is supported by counselor and A&M as well as monitoring and evaluation officer. They are supported by further outreach workers. These are the outreach workers who go to the communities to deliver the services as well as the information. These outreach workers are supported by community volunteers who are from the communities, and so far as their voluntary services are concerned, they are paid a minimum honorarium. For the prevention of HIV, we are following five key strategies in most of the NACP programs, that is prevention, treatment, information, education, communication, strategic information management systems, and institutional strengthening. Health belief model. We see that behavior change communication efforts by NACO are based in the health belief model, where a vulnerable person or an infected person is made to feel that a negative health condition, for example HIV, can be avoided. He or she has a positive expectation that by taking a recommended action like using of condom, health negative condition can be avoided. He believes that he can successfully take a recommended health action, that is comfortable and consistent use of condoms. The HBM was spelled out in terms of four constructs representing the perceived threat and net benefits. HBM was spelled out in terms of four constructs. Number one, perceived susceptibility. The person feels that he or she could be infected with HIV if he or she is behaving in a certain risky way. Second is perceived severity, that is the efficiency of the infection and frequency of contact or episodes of risk may underline the severity or maybe the presence of an STD. Next is perceived benefits, that is benefits of taking an HIV test, using condom or harm reduction or ART. The next is perceived barriers, that is the barrier of introducing condom in an already existing relationship or taking ART in front of family member. NACP 4, National AIDS Control Policy 4, this was launched by NACO to enhance the preventive efforts. It was meant to intensify and consolidate preventive services and expanding IEC, that is information, education and communication, comprehensive care, support and treatment, and strengthening institutional capacities and strengthening strategic information management system was the core issues of NACP4. Let us have a look at the community engagement in the context of HIV. There are pre-infection vulnerabilities. One needs to work around stigma and discrimination. One needs to work with internalized stigma and post-infection issues, physical and physiological, emotional or psychological. Let us see the summary. So this module explains the pandemic of HIV in India. It has many complexities attached with the illness, like negative social construction, stigma due to being a sexually transmitted infection. It is fatal and needs regular medication. Hence, the issue of stigma and disclosure leads to problem of non-adherence. This explains the HIV as an infection as well as a social issue due to rampant stigma associated with it. This is a result of negative social instruction due to marginalized people being the first target of the infection. This explains the reason of involving the communities of these people in reaching out to the hidden population for intervention purpose. National AIDS Control Organization, through its targeted intervention, has designed the intervention using the communities, including the target population, as well as the stakeholders who are in regular touch with the target population, hence are able to influence their behavior. Thank you.